Good afternoon, and welcome, especially to the newest members of our Blue Hen family to the University of Delaware. I am Monica Taylor, Vice President for Development and Alumni Relations at the University, and Chair of the Director of Athletics and Recreation Services Search Committee. In terms of our program this afternoon, in a few moments, you'll hear from University of Delaware President, Dr. Pat Harker, who will make remarks and introduce our new athletics director. Following his remarks, we will invite questions from the media and then invite you to join us for refreshments and an opportunity for you to meet and welcome our new athletics director to the university. It has been a pleasure to serve as chair of this search. This was a national search, and the committee reviewed the names of 79 official candidates. It was a great process, and I want to thank my colleagues who served on the search committee for their time, leadership, and efforts to recruit and attract the best person to the University of Delaware. I'm excited about the future of UD Athletics, and know we will be well positioned to take our programs to new levels of excellence in the years ahead under a new AD. With that, I'd like to introduce Dr. Pat Harker, President of the University of Delaware.
Well, good afternoon. I first want to take a moment to thank Monica Taylor and really the entire search committee, John Wallace, Ian Hennessy, Tina Martin, Lynn Snyder-Mackler, Matt Robinson, Michael Gilbert. They worked really hard, and I really want to thank them for their dedication to this process. And what they've shown through this process is their passion for UD Athletics and a keen understanding of the kind of leadership we need to take our intercollegiate and rec programs to the next level. The committee was appointed just 2 months ago, today. That's a lot of focused hard work over a very short period of time, and it's a credit to some really, really committed people. So let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. Where is she? There she is. I also want to thank Samantha Hughey for her service as interim AD. She is a terrific asset to this program, and I'm so grateful for her leadership and her guidance. Samantha, thank you. You know, when you're a school with only 5 athletic directors in its long history, today's a big deal, right? And when an athletics program is as important to this campus and to this community as ours, you have to make sure you're inviting someone in who shares the university's values and the community's values and has the experience, the character, and the vision to promote UD's growth in athletic competition and academic success. Without question, UD's athletics is a student-first program. The success of all our students on and off the field remains our top priority, and we will continue to challenge them to lead in sport, in scholarship, and in service. On occasions like these, it's tempting to recount UD's celebrated athletic tradition, but there's really no need. Most of the people in this room already know it by heart. They can rattle off the championship years and the teams and the scores. They can describe the victories like they happened yesterday. They can talk about the many, many people who built this program into what it is today. What we need now is someone who can keep building on this tradition of excellence, who can draw on the talents of an amazing group of coaches and staff, and grow the goodwill of a community of fans who still bleed blue and gold. When I appointed the search committee, I outlined what I believed Delaware's needs needed in its next AD. Someone with integrity, someone who will prioritize the needs and the experiences of our student athletes and put them at the center of our programs and decisions. Someone who is a pro, who understands college athletics and will continue the incredible professionalism we've maintained in our program. Someone who's an adept fundraiser for our student athletes and our athletic and recreational programs. Someone who's well known and well respected in college athletics, but it's simply someone with clout. And someone who can connect and engage with Delaware and Delaware's amazing fans. I am thrilled that we found that person in Eric Ziady. Eric has 22 years of experience in intercollegiate athletics. He's currently Senior Associate Athletic Director at Boston College, a great ACC school with a strong focus on the student athlete. BC has 31 athletic programs, 750 student athletes, more than one-third of them on full scholarship, and a $60 million annual budget. At 97%, BC's graduation success rate is number 2 in the nation. In his 14 years with Boston College, Eric's overseen long-range strategic and fiscal planning, as well as the day-to-day administration of all business and financial operations, and he counts 15 units under his management. He oversees five of BC's athletic programs, football, men's and women's golf, and men's and women's sailing. In 2010, Eric negotiated a multi-million dollar sponsorship agreement with Under Armour, the largest sponsorship deal in BC's athletics history. He was involved in the financial analysis and planning for the school's move to the ACC. Eric has served on a number of ACC committees and has chaired the conference's awards committee and women's golf committee. He served on the ACC and the Hockey East finance committees and on the competition committees in the America East and the Big East conferences. He's twice served on the NCAA certification subcommittees for fiscal integrity. Eric has a very strong background in financial administration, and he's a proven revenue generator. He understands the conference landscape and can help us navigate the thought process of conference alignment and realignment. He even knows Delaware, having been with Northeastern University in the 90s when both schools played in the America East. And finally, I know Eric shares our fundamental goal to serve and educate students who will lead in competition in the classroom and in the community. We're so happy that Eric's family could be here for this announcement. His mother, his two brothers, we could have interviewed you beforehand, and the younger brother, I'm a younger brother, always would, give the real dirt. But we're really glad you're here with your mom, and his wife Lauren and their children, Matthew, Lindsay, and Courtney. And you're such good children, this is fantastic. Please help me welcome Eric Ziady.
Thank you, President Harker, for your kind introduction. It's a sincere pleasure to be here with you today. I can't tell you how humbled and proud I am to be here and to be able to accept the offer to be your next athletic director. I want you to know first and foremost, I understand the rich history and tradition of Delaware Athletics, and I can't wait to work with this fine group of coaches, administrators, and staff in the years ahead as we build upon that great legacy. I want to thank a number of individuals who are instrumental in the search process, most notably Monica Taylor and the entire search committee. They provided me with incredible insight to both the university, the state of Delaware, the athletic program, and the special opportunities that this position will present for me and my family. I also want to thank Lori Wilder and Daniel Parker from Parker Executive Search for helping to facilitate the entire search process. And lastly, my deepest thanks to President Harker. President Harker has been instrumental in my decision to pursue this opportunity, and I appreciate your sharing your vision for the University of Delaware and your invitation to me to join your team as we work together in the years ahead. I want to take an opportunity to introduce my family again, who are here with me today. My mom, Ginny, my brothers, Craig and Mark, and the four people who you're going to see quite a bit of in the years ahead. I can promise you two things. You're going to see a lot of them, and we're never going to sneak up on you, okay? My son, Matthew, and my daughters, Lindsay and Courtney. And I also want to congratulate publicly my wife, who just got her PhD a week ago. So we have a full-fledged doctor in the house, and we couldn't... and our family couldn't be prouder and more appreciative of everything she does for our family. This speech today... We're really looking forward to settling in the Delaware community. This is an important time in our lives, both myself professionally and my family's lives. Our kids are young. We're looking to settle in this community and really excited about the opportunity for the next chapter of our lives being part of the Delaware family. My speech will be really short. I want to give you a brief personal introduction and five simple and powerful messages that will serve as our focal point in the years to come. I was first introduced to the University of Delaware, as President Harker said, when I was at Northeastern University starting my career in the early 90s. At that time, Delaware took the lead and hosted a number of the America East Conference Championships, a conference of which we were both members. And it was during those periods of time that I was able to come down with our team, visit Delaware, get to know the people, the facilities, and the incredible community support that Delaware enjoys. For the past 13 years, I've worked at Boston College, where I've been involved in all aspects of our athletic department, and most recently served as a senior associate athletic director. At BC, I've had the opportunity to work with and under one of the finest athletic directors in the country, Gene DeFilippo. He's allowed me to grow within the profession, and he's prepared me to lead a premier Division I program. I can't thank Gene or Boston College enough for the opportunities they've given me and my family over the past 13 years. Now, I carry into this position five simple messages. As a department, we'll always support the educational mission of this university. I understand, I'm comfortable with, and I want to be at an institution that shares the highest priority on its academic mission. Two, we're going to keep our student athletes at the center of everything that we do and as the focus of every decision we make as an administrative team here at Delaware. We'll remain focused on the experiences that they have, and we'll inspire, guide, and support them in their quest for comprehensive excellence, both athletically, academically, and socially. Three, we're going to engage the community. We'll invite the friends of this university and the fans of Blue Hen Athletics to connect with our department in a meaningful way. In doing so, we'll strive to clearly define our plans for the department and the opportunities to participate in the betterment of our student athletes. We'll maintain our integrity at all times. We won't cut corners, and we'll be totally compliant with university, conference, and NCAA rules and regulations. And last but not least, we want to be competitive. You know, I met with the coaches earlier, and I told them, I want to win as much as anybody. I'm not coming down here to lose. So I want to work with them. I want to partner with them in their quest for athletic excellence across the board here in our department. Delaware is a special and unique place. I realize the importance of its traditions, and I respect the legacy of the great administrators and coaches that have come before me, people such as David Nelson, Tubby Raymond, Edgar Johnson, and Mike Bray. And I can't wait to get to work to build upon the legacy in the years ahead. President Harker, thank you again for this wonderful opportunity, and I can't wait to get started. Yes.
Kevin. From the News Journal in Delaware. Welcome. You've come to a great place.
Thank you.
This has been a difficult time economically in college sports. You know, you're coming from a school with 31 sports. That's great. To a school that has more sports than anybody in its conference, except William & Mary. Last week, a lot of coaches around here really shuddered when Towson announced they were dropping men's soccer and baseball. How do you kind of maintain the tradition of keeping teams, making sure you can keep all these athletic teams in these economic times? I mean, how does that kind of rank as one of your challenges as you kind of take over this position?
Well, Kevin, that's a great question. I mean, that the economic challenges that we all face across the landscape in college athletics is the same everywhere, whether it be in some of the five big conferences that you know everyone thinks always has a lot of money. It's going to be a challenge, there's no question about it, but we're going to focus on the experience of our student athletes. We're going to invest in the programs that we have. We have no intention of dropping any further programs, and we're going to provide the support necessary for those sports to be successful as best we can. Matthew, do you have any questions?
Eric, when Bernard was here, you know, there was often kind of this feeling that he was passing through, and you know, a lot of that is because he was very talented and people knew that, but he was just kind of passing through. Using this as a stepping stone to the next job. Again, he's a very talented guy. You can see why, why that would be a perception. But that did kind of ruffle some feathers of a lot of Delaware fans. How do you kind of some coaches around here have kind of referred to the fractured fan base that we have here. Football attendance has dropped a little bit. How do you kind of go about trying to, you know, reconnect? You know, you kind of talked about it a little bit, engaging. How do you go about trying to kind of smooth that out and redevelop that connection?
It's going to be an ongoing challenge. I mean, obviously, I need to come down here. I need to spend some time listening. I need to spend some time learning what the environment is down here. Engaging the community, there are many facets to that. I'm going to build a great team. We've got a great team. I know I've met a number of them this morning, and I'm going to rely on them for their knowledge of the situation here in Delaware, and I'm going to be out in the streets with them every day on the front lines.
When you were at Northeastern and coming here for the American East basketball tournament or whatever, what was it about Delaware that struck you as this being a special place?
They always beat us. No, I mean, first and foremost, and this, remember, this was 16, 17 years ago, so I think this building here was pretty new at the time. I was struck by, you know, the experience that our kids had. It was a very first-rate operation in putting on the America East Championship. We had a time, you know, and with a basketball tournament, you have a chance to spend a few days here versus, you know, you're just in and out in one day. So I had an opportunity to spend some time on campus, the opportunity to spend some time downtown, to walk up and down the streets of Main Street and see Delaware gear everywhere. You know, we have a great following and a great fan base at Boston College, but you know, I remember a few years back we were number two in the country in football, and the Red Sox were in the playoffs, and we were on page six. So, you know, it's a different ball game, and there's good and bad to that. There's good and bad to everything. But, you know, I always impressed with the people, the campus, and the interest in the community here at Delaware, and that they beat us. But, well, I don't know. I have a 5-year budding hockey star here, so we were very happy to see the rink next door.
All right, great.
Thank you.